Very good morning, my dear students. So today I'll going to discuss about the graphical program. So in this graphical program, what you will going to have, you find it that this particular graphical program we will going to have here. We will going to have here the structures that we are formatting here and how to make the particular structures. So in this particular thing, what you will going to see that there we today we will going to discuss about a Python panda programming, and in this particular programming data visualization with using the matplot, isn't it? So let us see how the what are the programs there and how we can make this particular program to be workable. So let's see what is the today's program. So first program you can see here, in this particular program what you have here matplotlib. In this particular matplotlib, what has been done here, from matplotlib import pyplot spt, that means totally in a different way I have declared it here. Okay, totally in a different way that I have declared the program. So as you find it, in a different way I have declared the program. In this particular section, what has been done, that from matplotlib, okay, from matplotlib, what import pyplot as plt, what we are doing, matplot dot pyplot as plt, import matplot dot pyplot as plt. But here what we are doing it here, we find it that in this particular area or in this particular part that we are having the structures, we are making the particular structure. This particular structures is what that we are having a pyplot, and we are implementing the pyplot as what, as a matplotlib, isn't it? So this is what the matplot that has been used, and that we find it that we can have it. Okay, now in this particular structures, in this particular part that where we are having the particular matplot as a pyplotlib, we are calling it here. Now here what we can find, that I have given here x and y, so some values of x and some values of y. So those the values of x and those the values of y, what it has been called, plt dot plot x comma y. Clear? X comma y has been called here, and as we are calling here the x comma y, we find it that those the particular structures, those the particular sections that we are making it, we are implementing it, then what has been done here, plt dot plot, that means I am calling here plt plot x comma y. Okay, next what I have done here, I have done here that particular structures to be worked, that title. Okay, next ylib some y axis, xlib x axis, plt short show. So this is the thing what has been done. Now from this particular thing, what are the differences that you can find, what are the differences that you can work with? Okay, the differences that you can find, or differences that you are working with, that here I have an called the matplotlib as import. Okay, so what I am saying here, that from matplotlib, that means this is also the one way that we can call the particular program. Okay, this is also one way that we can call the particular program, and we can do the particular program. Clear? So this the particular program what we are calling, what we find it, that we are having here x and y. The value of x and y is there, and when we find the value of x and y is there, in this particular x and y value, what we are doing, we are making this particular form. What is a form? Form is that a matplotlib to be imported in a pyplot system. Okay, so pyplot system, as we are calling the pyplot, so this is the particular pyplot what we are using, what we are making, isn't it? So each of this particular pyplot, what we find it, that each and every pyplot is there, and that we will going to construct. That means that we are going to construct in this particular manner or in this particular way. Okay, so in this particular manner or in this particular way, when we are constructing it from Matplotlib, what we are doing, we are importing it. Okay, we are importing it. So as we are importing it, we find it that how the thing can be executed, how we can make the particular thing to be executed, isn't it? So these the executions that we find, this is the part of executions that we can implement it here, that we make it here, that they will going to have the structures, and they will going to make the structures wherever you need to implement and what way you need to implement. That is also a very important thing, that how you are implementing the structures, how you are making the structures to be workable. So this working feature of the structures, you find it that are being done in a way that we are first declaring it here, what the two thing, the value of x and the value of y. Okay, so value of x and value of y, that means this is the value of x and value of y, what has been declared it here. You see, some balance has been kept in the particular area, isn't it? Some balance we have kept in the particular area. So in this particular area, what we find it, that as we are making, as we are plotting, as we are working with it, this is the particular work that we find, this is the particular work we can find, how we can make the particular sections, how we can call the particular sections. What we do, that plot, plt dot plot, isn't it? PLT dot plot means we are plotting the structures, we are making the structures to be workable. Clear? So what we are plotting, this is the value of x and the value of y that has been given there. That means we have given there two values, one the value of x, one is the value of y. So as we have given those the value of x and value of y, that means this the value will be called here, they will be plotted here. Where it will be going to plot? It will be going to plot with the help of an PLT. So what is that PLT? PLT means a pie plot system. Now what this pie plot system is coming from the Matplotlib. That means inside the Matplotlib, we are calling this particular structures and we are making these structures to be implementable. Okay, so this is how what we can find, this is how what we can see, that as we are making our structures, as we are calling the particular structures, we find it that all these particular structures, what is there, all the particular structures that we will going to frame it, we will going to frame it in a particular form, in a particular way. So those the particular structures that we are framing, those the particular work that we are making, what we are doing now, we are can design it. That is a secondary matter, that how we are designing it. Do we need to design it in a certain way? Do you need to design it in a certain form, or we don't need to design the particular thing? So that is totally what we can find it, that we can have this particular structures and we can make the particular structures to be worked with, isn't it? So those the working feature, those the working part of the designing pattern, those the working way of our designing pattern, that how we are making the structures and how we are working with the structures. We have to see this particular thing, we have to find this particular thing, that what are the sections that we are using here. So what I have called here, I have called here the title, I have called here Y level, I have called here X level, and I have called here show. So those the four things what I have called here, they are been used, they are been maintained in this particular certain way or in a particular form, that we can implement it and we can make or we can construct one structures there, isn't it? So as we can construct one structures, as we can make one structure, so this is the structures what we find, this is the structures that you have seen it, that we are working on this particular structures, we will going to have the particular format, and we are making this format for what purpose? For the purpose of the implementation of your particular graph, isn't it? So what is the graph that we are plotting? by seeing the values we can see the value and we can get it that what pattern of graph that we are plotting it here. That means we have here two set of values, okay, one set of x value and one set of y value. So as we are having these two set of value, you can see here that we have keep some similarities between the value, like 5 to 7 and 2 16 and 4, isn't it? So 16 is what, it is an very big difference that has been given there, but we have kept it, we have merged it in this particular manner, and we have kept it in a particular manner. Now let us see what is the output of it. Now you see that when we are having these particular structures, when we are constructing the particular structures, in these structures what we have the x-axis and y-axis. So this is the x-axis, as I have named it here only the x-axis, and this has been named at y-axis. So as we have named them, there are the values are there, see, 2, 4, 6, 16, then 12, 14 and 16. That means these the differences or these the dividations has been done by whom? Done by the Python itself. Number 1, and here you can find 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So all these things what we can find it, this is also been done by whom? This is also been done by the Python itself. Previous program you have seen it that we have a dividation of 0.2 or somewhere there is a dividation of 0.5. So 0.2, 0.5, when we are having that particular pattern of dividation, when we are making that particular pattern of dividations, we are working on this particular structures, okay, we are making on this particular pattern, clear? So this is the particular pattern of the work that we are implementing it here. We are making the work to be implemented, and we can see it that how the particular work can be working in this area. Clear? So this is how you can find it, this is how we can see it, that we have a different type of structures that we are working with, and we are making the particular structures, okay, we are finding those particular structures. So as we are finding those structures, as we are making those structures, as we are having those particular pattern of the structures, what we have, there are the different pattern that we can implement, there are the different phase that we can implement it here, okay. So this is how we can find it, that how we can implement the particular pattern of the structures as in x and y phases. See here the value of x and y, that means 2 and 16. So 2 and that particular point that you find it, that 16 at the top it has started, and two lines and they has been started in this way, that means 5 and 2, then it reached to 16, that it came into 5 and 7, isn't it? So this is how we can find it, that we can construct the structures and we can make the structures. Now see, let us see what is the next program is there. Now see, in the next program is very much important, lot of thing has been used here, that what has been given here from matplotlib import pyplot as plt, okay. So from matplotlib what we are importing, we are importing here the pyplot as plt, okay. So this is the thing has been imported here. Next, what has been imported here from matplotlib import styles also been imported here, okay. So this is the thing what we can find it, the two thing has been imported here from the matplotlib. So from the matplotlib what we find, that two things has been imported, and those the two things what is imported there, they are one is a pyplot and one is a style, isn't it? So these are the two things what we can find, they has been imported here and they has been used here. So this is the thing what we can see, this is the part that we can find here, that when we are importing those particular sections, when we are making those particular section, so each of these sections are being used and utilized in this way. Next, what we can find, that there is a style.use ggplot, that means we have called here one use function. Okay, this particular use function has been called here. Now you see here what how we have designed it. First we have given the value of x, some value of x 5, 8 and 10, then I have given the value of y 12, 16 and 6, then what has been given, value of x2, okay, x2 what is there, x2 is 6, 9 and 11, then has been given y2 is what, 6, 15 and 7, clear? So this is the thing what you can find, that it has been given. Now you see here plt dot plot x comma y, okay, then what is that g level, line 1, line width, that means how much the line width is, that line width has been declared. Next see plt plot x2 y2 e, it has been leveled, and line 2, that is a line width has been given. Next what you can see, the title has been given, y level given, x level given, legend has been given. Now see grid. Grid means at the background what you see, there are the lines are been there in your graph page. Okay, so if you want to implement that line, then you can use a grid. Grid is what true, and color is what K. What is the K color, that you will see when we will operate it, and plt dot show. This is the thing what you can find. This is the part that we can find. That means what we are calling here, basically we are calling here the pyplot as plt. So pyplot has been called here as plt. Matplotlib. Matplotlib has been imported here as type. Isn't it? So these are the two things has been imported here. After using these two things, what you can find it here, the style dot use gg dot plot. Okay, style dot use gg dot plot has been used here, and using that gg dot plot, what we can find here, that some value of x has been given. X has given 5, 8 and 10, y has been given 12, 16 and 6, and similarly x2 has been given what, 6, 9 and 11, and y2 has been given 6, 15 and 7. Isn't it? Now you see here that when we are plotting it here, we are giving some name, that xyg. Okay, and that is an E face. So this is the thing what we are giving here. After that, these two has been combined and form into one particular pattern. These two has been combined and form into one particular pattern. Isn't it? Line width also has been declared, that what should be the line width of a program is. Okay, now the title has been given. After the title, y level has been given, x level has been given, and as we have given x level and y level, there is a legend also been imported here. And what is the main important thing is there, that you are implementing here, that is what, the grid. Okay, grid has been given here. How the grid will be, how we can, grid means at the backside what we can find, the backside of a particular program, you can find that there is a line will going to come, isn't it? So those the line what you can find it, that will going to come, that is said as a grid. So the grid has also been implemented here. Implementing the grid, the particular program is on work. Now let us see what is the output of this particular program is. Now you see this particular output. See how beautiful the output is, how beautiful it has been designed, and how beautiful the thing has been implemented, isn't it? So you can see here this particular structure, what is there, that there are the two lines. So line 1 and line 2, as it is named, isn't it? Now this is the axis, as you are taking it, you can see the axis. See the axis values are also there. This is y axis, this is x axis. As it has been combined as E and F, you can see it. G means an green color, and E means this particular color. Okay, so color has also been specified for it, and after the color has specified for it, see gridding. See gridding is K. K means there will be a shade, ash shade with an black color of gridding is there. See, these the gridding are there. Okay, so as it is same as it is like your graph paper. So thing has been done, thing has been replicated as a graph paper, and you are arranging it as the graph paper is. So this is what you can find it, this is what you can see, that when you are making the particular structures, when we are having those particular structures, so each and every structures what we have, what we find it, that they will going to have a form, and they will going to make a form in this particular way or in this particular manner. Okay, so this is how you can see it, this is how you can find it, that how you can construct the particular structure. So beautifully designed the structure is, and it has been made in a very beautiful way. Okay, the thing has been made in a very beautiful way, because you can find here that as your graph paper, the grid has been done, then the color has been given, isn't it? And after the color, there are the level has been given, the name of the table has been given, and after the name of the table, you have find the legend. So this is the coloring section. That means when you are calling the color, when you are making the color part, that means what will be the color. So you can change the color according to your wish, according to your pattern, isn't it? You can give a red color, yellow color, blue color, whatever the color you want, what pattern of color you find it good to be presented, that particular color you can bring it there, and you can make it in this way. Okay, so this is how you can construct the graph. So much modification now you see that we have done, that when we have started the graph, from that basic pattern to so much modification has been done in this particular graph that has been used here. Isn't it? A lot of modifications we have done. That means all the things that has been described in the CBSE norms as per your CBSE curriculums, that also has been, that all the thing has been implemented here, all the things has been shown here. Grading, then the line color, then the background phase, then the legend, then the particular graph headings, axis name, isn't it? So all these things, everything, every part, plotting, legend, Y level, X level, level naming, how to do the leveling name, etc. All these things has been done, and all the points has been touched. So see, this is what is your graph. So thank you. Today I am ending my today's session here. Thank you all.